If you're a vegetarian looking for some new sources of protein, I think you'll find this video very useful. I've put together a list of 10 vegetarian and vegan protein sources, most of which you may have not known about, thought about, or even recognized as protein sources. So no, this isn't going to be your typical beans and tofu vegetarian kind of video. These are new sources. As a vegetarian and as a vegan, as long as you vary your protein sources and have the right macronutrient balance, there's no reason why you can't experience amazing results, gain muscle, burn fat, and look your absolute best. Let's go over some of these new protein sources that are plant-based. My favorite is black bean and mung bean pasta. Quinoa and chickpea pasta used to be the go-to pasta for extra protein, but the newer black bean and mung bean pastas have way better macro ratios. In one serving of black bean pasta, you're getting a whopping 25 grams of protein and only 17 grams of carbs. Compare that to your regular wheat-based pasta and you'll see a completely different label. It's going to have over 40 grams of carbs and only roughly 8 grams of protein. The best part is that black bean pasta doesn't really taste like black beans, and if you add a little bit of sauce, it tastes really, really good. There's also another carb that's made up of live grains that packs a surprisingly high amount of protein. I'm talking about Ezekiel bread. It's made up of wheat, barley, beans, lentils, millet, and spelt, which ultimately creates a complete source of protein full of all the essential amino acids. In one Ezekiel bun, there's 9 grams of protein and 34 grams of carbs. Even though this protein to carb ratio is not as good as the black bean pasta, it's still really good. Black beans, which are considered a staple vegetarian protein source, will have only a slightly better protein to carb ratio. Next is seitan, and I'm surprised that a lot of vegetarians have never heard of this awesome protein source. It comes from gluten, so it's not for everyone, not for the gluten intolerant or people with celiac disease. But other than that, it's one of the best plant-based sources of protein. It's not a complete source of protein, but something simple like soy sauce can be added in to make it a complete source. Seitan has 21 grams of protein per serving and usually under 5 grams of carbs. When you cook it right, it comes out with a chewy texture, and with the right sauce, it might become one of your favorite protein sources. For the fourth plant-based source of protein, we got nutritional yeast. Before you make up your mind that you don't want to eat any kind of yeast, I want you to know that I've tried this and it's actually really good. On top of that, in just 2 tablespoons, you're getting 7 grams of protein and only 6 grams of carbs. Again, this is another truly awesome protein to carb ratio for a vegan approved complete source of protein packed with all the essential amino acids that your body needs. You can also use it in a lot of recipes, including healthy mac and cheese recipes, mashed cauliflower recipes, salads, and much, much more. What do we got next? That's right, peanut butter. But not just any kind of peanut butter, because regular peanut butter does come with a lot of fat and some excess carbs. We're gonna wanna go with a dehydrated form of peanut butter like PB2. With PB2, you'll see right on the front of the label, they claim that there's an 85% reduction in the amount of fat calories than regular peanut butter. In 2 tablespoons, you'll be getting 5 grams of protein and 5 grams of carbs and only 1.5 gram of fat. 2 tablespoons of regular peanut butter has 16 grams of fat. Another protein source you may have never heard of and could be a great snack for vegans and vegetarians alike is vegan jerky. The company that makes it has a bunch of different flavors to choose from, and the smoked black pepper version has 7 grams of protein and 4 grams of carbs and 3.5 grams of fat. This is again a great macronutrient ratio for a vegan snack. You can order them right from Amazon if you don't have a store that sells it near you. Up next is tempeh and tofu, and the reason why I group these together is because they both come from soy. Also, one of the best ways to make both of these taste good is by sauteing them with seasoning and sauce. The main difference is that tempeh is less processed than tofu. Just to compare the two, in 1 cup of tempeh, you're getting 30 grams of protein, 15 grams of carbs, and about 18 grams of fat. With tofu, you're getting 20 grams of protein, about 5 grams of carbs, and 12 grams of fat in just 1 cup. So tempeh is a lot more calorically dense, but in either case, both of these are great sources of protein that you could use as an alternative to meat-based sources. Moving on, we all know about chia seeds and flax seeds being higher in protein, but a lot of people don't know about hemp seeds and hemp hearts, which is basically a shelled hemp seed. In 1/4 cup of hemp hearts, there's about 15 grams of protein, 5 grams of carbs, and 15 grams of fat. Again, these macronutrient ratios are great for a vegetarian source of protein, and there are many great claimed health benefits for hemp seeds, none of which have been fully proven through scientific studies yet. For the next protein source on the list, I have spirulina. Spirulina is a blue-greenish algae that has a ridiculous amount of protein as well as tons of antioxidants and nutrients. In just 3 tablespoons, you're going to be getting 12 grams of protein, about 4 grams of carbs, and only 1.5 grams of fat. Guys, that's amazing for a plant-based source of protein. But spirulina doesn't really taste good on its own. You might want to add it to a protein shake or a juice that you make, or you might want to go with spirulina capsules to avoid that taste. Last but not least are protein and meat replacement products. As far as vegan protein sources, rice protein is one of the most absorbable, but there are plenty of different types of protein powders to choose from, including hemp, rice, soy, and pea protein, just to name a couple. These protein powders can be used to help you get some extra protein in the same way that you would use whey protein. Also, Gardena makes a lot of meat replacement products that are totally plant-based and they taste great. If you have this brand at your local supermarket, I would definitely recommend trying some out, especially for the convenience sake that it offers. That's pretty much it, guys. There are plenty of other great sources that I didn't mention in today's video. Grains like quinoa, buckwheat, barley, couscous, and oats are all higher in protein than most other grains. Vegetarians can incorporate things like Greek yogurt, eggs, cottage cheese, and ricotta cheese, as well as even regular whey protein. And of course, the traditional sources of protein for vegans like beans, lentils, legumes, and edamame are all still great plant-based sources of protein. I really hope this video has helped you guys out and that you've learned some new non-meat plant-based sources of protein. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you subscribe to this channel and also visit my website gravitytransformation.com where we have done for you diet and workout plans that are proven to work. I'll see you guys soon. Pump it.